Okay, the day is here that I'm going to pull off my old Biesemeier guide rail, my original one that I've had that's now bent after locking my T-square down to it a couple hundred thousand times at least. And I'm going to put on the new one that I made. The green back there is the angle iron 3x3 by a quarter inch, and then the blue is the new 2x3 11 gauge tubing. And I've got everything, you know, pretty much ready to do to go. I do have some drilling that I'm going to have to do on this that I wasn't really sure where it was going to be until I actually pulled the old one off. And so I'm going to have a. This is going to probably be a little bit more complicated than if you were just doing it from scratch yourself. I've got kind of a complicated setup to deal with here. So the very first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to pull out my box down below, and I've got a plywood dolly that I'm just going to pull the drawers out. I'm just going to slip that on there. But you can see this big bar of steel that I have on here. This is one of my most prized junk items. And what that is, I got that at the junkyard, and I paid $15 for it at my junkyard before they stopped selling to us normal people and everything just started going into recycling. But that is a blade from a very huge sheet metal shear, and that is some incredibly high quality hardened steel. I mean, it's a steel cutting steel blade, and I just kick myself every time I look at that thing, because there were 12 or 14 of those things there and they were $15 a piece, and just being cheap, I only took one. And the thing is over 12 feet long, and it's as straight as an arrow. It doesn't matter where I put my mitutoyo on it, it's straight. And it's got those threaded holes in there, so that's how you would bolt it into the machine if you were going to change the blades. But it's a pretty neat thing. So I'm using it here as a straight guide, and let me show you how I'm using it. So this is one of the reasons I've kind of put off doing this, because I knew mine was going to be a little bit complicated. See the way I've got this green sheet metal here? This is 11 gauge, and it bolts to the angle iron, and this is where my sliding table goes. And I've got this all incredibly precisely aligned, and so I don't want to mess up the alignment too much. And so it just took me a little while to figure out how to do this. So I milled a board up exactly as high as the top of my table saw. Now I've got these big Bessie Rapids pinning this down. And then I've got some clamps here that are reaching underneath and clamping the steel reference bar to my table saw. So this cannot move, and each one of these units is now isolated and held in place. And so I should be able to drop this off, and without moving this or messing this up very much. And so when I get this off, I'll be able to take very accurate measurements to know where to re-drill into my new green here. See, I haven't done any of my drilling into here, so I'm gonna have to do that. But I've got my drill press completely ready and set up over here. You can see it's back over here. I've got the long extension on it, and with my two outfeed supports, and so I'm really ready to just get on with this and get this done. Now my table is a little different than the way some people do. I like to make a wooden frame, and you're not going to really be able to see that until I pull this off. I make a wooden frame, and then I screw plywood down to the wooden frame, and then I skin it with laminate. And then that wooden frame is pinned between the angle iron front and back. And that's how I do this. Now I'm still just completely right here. I'm pretty darn close here too. So 20 years later, I'm still pretty much in line. You know, I'm gonna work on this a little bit, but I've got this at this end down here. I've got the end of the table clamped, because when I do release this here, this is going to want to fall a little bit. So I'm going to, you know, but I want to keep it kind of isolated. I'm not replacing the angle iron on the back. That's completely fine. I'm going to leave that in place. But when I free this, you know, I've got, that's why I've got this prop support down here. So now this is going to be held up. So really the only place it's going to want to try to fall and sag is up here where it's not supported by this angle iron anymore. But once I get this box out, and I can prop this up and, you know, make sure that it's good and solid. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention that, you know, my saw is on these big, heavy industrial casters, and I don't want this thing moving around. I want everything completely isolated. And so I've got it blocked up. You can see the way I've got it blocked up here. I just levered the saw up with a good stout piece of Liptus and slipped blocks underneath all four corners. So, you know, it can't move on me. Just trying to keep everything. I just want to try to bolt everything back the way it came off. So here's my box getting ready to come out from underneath there. It's pretty good size. I mean, I think you get an idea really how much volume of storage there is in this thing when you see it out. Here are all my drawers stacked up back over here. So let me take this guy apart. So cheesy to have just this little tiny porch for this to, you know, this tubing to sit on. Just, you know, they couldn't give you a 3x3. They had to say, no, we're gonna save money by a 3x2. That just doesn't make any sense. Okay, now that I've got this box out of here, I can kind of, you know, things are starting to fall into place. I can get a hand screw up here and I can pin my framework to the inside of the webbing of the cast iron extension wing. So now this won't fall. This isn't going to want to fall. So I got it supported out there by the bar and the leg, the kicker going all the way down to the ground. Now I've got it pinned here. So now I can feel confident I can pull this angle iron off without any problem.